I wanted to briefly talk about private. Why are all of these things private? Why is that? It's not mandatory, but it's like 90% of your classes will have private fields. Well, why? If I, another good example is in student. Let's have our student have age or private int age, something like that. Let's make it public for starters, so just so we can see something. Now, inside of the main program here, I can say student1.age equals minus 25. I mean, this is completely valid because I'm accessing age directly. I cannot prohibit anyone from setting the age to minus 25, you know. So anybody using my student class can set age to minus 25 because it's public. You can do whatever you want with it, you know. This is not really valid. I mean, I don't want to allow age to be set to a negative number because that will just break all kinds of hell later on, right? So basically what you want to do is you want to make your variables private just so you have more control over them. And what do I mean with more control? Now you cannot access it directly. You can only access it via constructors or public methods. So now if I create a constructor that has age in here, so let's do the constructor with all of these parameters. Now age is passed in here. If the age, and now I can literally say if age is less than zero, do something, otherwise set the age to this one, you know, to this value. If the age is less than zero, again, I'm just showing you this because this exists and we will cover this, I'm assuming like 3-4 lessons, not really sure, but yeah, we're throwing an exception. We're gonna say throw an exception. You've already seen exceptions when, for example, you try to access like 10th element of a 5-element array. Well, Java throws an exception. You're just doing something that you're not supposed to do. And here you're setting an age that you're not supposed to set. So yeah, it's fine that your program should crash. You're not being nice with your usage of our classes, right? So this is the proper way, but the improper way is we can just say this dot age equals like zero, you know, a baby enrolled in college or something, whatever. But we don't want to allow negative numbers. So here you can see that our age variable cannot ever be set to negative number. If you pass a negative number, we're setting it to zero. We don't care. Or we can, if age is less than zero, we can even be smarter and like multiply it with negative one. If somebody has passed like minus 18, we can just say, okay, then it's going to be 18. You know, I mean, I'm just messing about here. You're never going to do this. This is just stupid, but you get the idea. We can literally manipulate this in any way we want, because this is our class. Nobody is going to upset a negative age in our class, right? I'm going to leave this as it is just so you can see. I mean, this way you can never have a negative age, basically. And what we've done is since we've made age private, you can never directly access this value. You can never either read or change it at this point. That's why I'm hoping that now we're going to getters and setters. Yeah, that's a good segue. We're getting to getters and setters. Well, since all of these variables are private, well, it would appear they are useless. How do I print something out? How do I print the name of the student? Like student1.name, and it's complaining. I cannot access anything from a student. And if I just start to want to type my student to the, you know, console, this happens. It says com.company.student at this location. So this is probably its memory location. So this doesn't tell me too much, right? So how do we, I mean, are these classes really useless, or are we going to create something to access those fields? We are going to create something, and those things that are used to get the fields are called getters, and we also have setters, and you will see both of them shortly. So let's just create a getter, get age. Of course, Java, I mean, IntelliJ is just like on top of things. It's offering, when you start typing get age, just offering you, you know, everything, the getters for everything. But the basically a getter is nothing more than a simple method. We can type it on our own. Public, what do we want to return? Let's create a getter for name first. So what are we returning? We're returning a string, public string. How do we call it? The most common, not really the most common, but the way that you want to name your getters is get and then the name of the variable. Of course, since this is camel case, n is going to be uppercase, even though here it was lowercase. You just, you know, always want to start your methods with the lowercase and keep on doing camel case. Get name, it doesn't have any parameters, because why would we need parameters? We don't need to pass anything there. We're just expecting to get the name. And this is basically how your getter should look like. This is a really simple method, but it's public. Now we have created a read-only name, basically. You know, we can read it, we can get the name, but we cannot change it, right? So sometimes you want to have something like that, you know. You don't have to have both the getter and the setter. Sometimes you just want one, sometimes you want the other one. And the setter, of course, would be something along the lines of it doesn't return anything, so it's void. It's called set name, right? This one does take a parameter. Why does it take a parameter? Well, basically because we need to specify the thing that we're setting our name to. And what we're doing is this.name equals name. This looks a lot, an awful lot like a constructor in regards to this, but it's just setting one field, right? And your getters and setters also shouldn't be doing anything other than just the thing that they're meant to do, which is getting the data, setting the data. We're not going to have more code here. We're not going to do any manipulations here in the setter. That would just be, I mean, defying all the conventions in the world. So just don't do that. Okay, so this would be a getter and a setter for your field. Here you can see now when we're creating a setter for an age, we can now in the setter as well have our logic, something like if age is less than zero, well, then do something, otherwise set the age properly. And here we can say like age equals minus age, basically this dot age. Yeah, I think this works. Like minus age would do the same thing as minus one times age. Since it's not complaining, I'm assuming that that's what it does. Okay, so you can see here now, we even provided a way to modify the age, but we still have a way to like police or to control the way that we're modifying age, you know? So that's the thing. That's the thing about private and public. We provide a method, and inside of the method, we have much more control of what you're doing. If we just provide you the naked variable, you can do with the variable whatever you want. There's no way in Java to prevent something like student1.age equals minus 25, unless you make it private, you know? So that's the main point. I know that certainly I was wondering when I was learning programming, like why the hell do we have private and public and so on, you know? Seems like kind of unnecessary, but this is why we have it. And also some languages don't even have them. So they're not obligatory, but they're useful, you know? Okay, it's all about who has the responsibility. Like you here remove the responsibility from the programmer. He just cannot access that and that's it, you know? But in some languages, they opted to give you the responsibility. Like if you wanna set the age to negative 25, who cares, you can do it, you know? Java hasn't opted for that, and I think that's fine too. Okay, so these are your getters and setters. Again, setters will usually look something like this set name setter. I mean, they will usually be one-liners like this, and getters will almost always be one-liners like that. So this would be the most common way to do them, but I just wanted to show you that if you're not accepting some data, you know, like, we can even try to like give a grade, and then like if the grade is not between 5 and 10, we can say that's an improper grade or something like that, you know. So you do assume that some pieces of data do have some constraints, you know. It's not a stupid question, it's a really good question. Why aren't these static methods? Well, we already talked about static methods and non-static, and variables can be static and non-static. Every student that we create, like student one, student two, student three, they will have their own fields. Each one will have each of these fields for themselves. Same thing about methods. When we call get name, it needs to access that student's name. If we made it static, there would only be one get name per class. And which name would it get? If I make this static, it's not a stupid question at all. It's a really valid question. Well, now, if there is only one method for the whole class called getName, which student's name is it taking? You cannot access it. Here it's saying basically you're trying to reference a non-static field from a static context. That's not fine. The other way around, it kind of works, you know. So, for example, if I have, I don't know, like private static max grade int max grade. Max grade would be like 10, whatever. Very stupid example because it's useless basically. But we can have a method called getMaxTrade. We can get rid of static and it still works. Why? Well, because every student can access the thing that belongs to all the students, but it doesn't work the other way around. I hope you understand my point. So when there is, this belongs to the whole class, so every student has access to it. But since, like, from something that exists for the whole class, only one of them, how can it access a specific student or a specific something, you know? It cannot. So you cannot access non-static things for us from a static context. That's basically, but if you think about it, don't remember this in a way of static, non-static, just remember it in a way like, how can, there is only one of this method for the whole class. How can it access like 10 different student names? It cannot. It cannot access this variable, you know. And the other way around, it just works, you know, because this is, you know, the whole class. This belongs to the whole class, so each student, I mean, can access it, you know. Okay, that's the thing, and it's really a fine question as well, because these static, non-static things also confused me at the start as well. So we do need to be talking about them, like, probably even more than we have already.